Hello everyone, this video is part of AZ100 for Microsoft Azure Administrator Training. For the complete course, please check the link in the description of this video. And we will start with identity governance. 10 years ago, cloud solutions began to grow so fast that right from that moment, it was necessary for many organizations to change the process of governance controls, to monitor the user access, and to reinvent the lifecycle in terms of user management. The identity governance is coming with a new life cycle that allows you to balance your organization's need for security and the employee productivity with the right process and visibility. It provides you capabilities to ensure that the right people have the right access to the right resources. Identity governance gives organizations the ability to do the task across employees, business partners and vendors, and across services and applications both on-premise and in the cloud, such as govern the identity lifecycle, govern access lifecycle, and secure privileged access for administration. Identity lifecycle helps organizations achieve a balance between productivity, for example, how quickly can a person have access to the resource they need, such as when they join the organization, and in security terms, how should their access change over time, such as due to changes to that person's employment status. Access lifecycle, organizations need a process to manage access beyond what was initially provisioned for a user when that user's identity was created. Furthermore, enterprise organizations need to be able to scale efficiently to be able to develop and enforce access policy and controls on an ongoing basis. Privileged access is a key part of identity governance, especially given the potential for misuse associated with those administrator rights that can cause an organization. The employees, vendors, and contractors that take on administrative rights need to be governed. The three life cycles that we have discussed now intend to help organizations address these four key questions. Which users should have access to which resources? What are those users doing with that access? Do you do effective organizational controls for managing access? Can auditors verify that the controls are working? If you have answered to these four questions, you will be able to build a robust lifecycle process for your clients.